I actually was gonna make a. Oh, I had like big plans, you know, to make this poetic video on the bright moon. You know, we had a very, very beautiful bright moon last night, and probably it'll be there again tonight. When we have this bright moon, it's just like such like an impact on that level of. It's like an ordainment of the self. You know, such a bright moon. That it casts away all of the stars. None of the stars could even exist in the sky. The moon is that bright, you know what I'm saying? So it's a reflection on the self, you know. It's like, how bright do you want to be, you know, that you're in the destruction of others? Or is that our society that we only want one bright, so no stars other exist, you know? There's just so many plays on this moon out there. Like what's it all about? You know, what's this moon all about? You know, what's it representing right now in this time? Because in essence the moon is like a moon I've never seen before. You know, it's its first time in this calendar era of this world production. You know, the moon is having its first impact on the planet, you know, last night, to be that bright. You know, it's expressing so many lumens, you know. So it's all about this the competition self existing also. It brings that into your head, you know. It's the competition self, you know. There can only be one, you know. Nobody else exists, you know. So it's kind of a drama. It's kind of a drama moon, isn't it? One that is just like a wretched. It's a wretched taker. It's a wretched taker of extraordinary. Where all else pales. You know what I'm saying? So if all else is paling, what, there was just like some disjunctive over there that thought it was a twinkling star, something over there, another one, you know. No, it's just the moon. That is it. You know, just like, not even a choice. It's almost like a commercial. It's almost like a commercial that people are fed, and they're fed, and they're fed, and they're fed. And so they know only that particular statement. They only know that bit of information. And so they refeed it. They know only that there is a bright moon. You know, it was that powerful a moon that it commercialized itself. You know, it brought itself into star status. What? It was the only star. So yeah. What a nature last night. What a nature. I don't know. It's kind of a strange in reflection, you know, I'm dealing with this switch over from, what do you call that, the sing-along opera diva to the, oh my gosh, you know, soloist all on my own with these instrumentals, you know, only instrumentals, you know, trying to, you know, re-diva. So it's an odd thing, you know. I do feel like one of those distant stars that wanted to speak, you know, that wanted to sing, you know, wanted to express, and yet, oh, no, you know, it's just that, no, you haven't crossed over, you know. The instrumentals are mean. And not all songs qualify as jumping into. I've just had head training. I've had amazing head training from the divas, from the great divas. You know, amazing, amazing voices I've been hearing and listening to and tuning and toning with, and oh my gosh, they're gone. You know, when you're the soloist only, they're not there. You know, my crutch. They're not there. It's just this instrumental, and then you'll have like, darian, 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 zonk, nothing. And go, oh my gosh, I think I need the score right now. And then I'm like, uh-oh, do I even read music that great? Because I have to know the note. The arrangement of those notes. You know, I don't have their little cute little zzzz-a-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da So my what do I call myself? The mimicker, the copier. I guess the copier. I guess a tone. Well, no, it's not a tone copier. It's more a score copier. Score copier self. I can't. I can just only go on memory, or revert to the score. And oh my gosh, what a drudge haul. I don't want to be a killer of the planet with trees. And so we have all of these, what do we call it? We have these videos that have the scores. And so somebody has done that. I just can't look at the computer all the time. I cannot look at the computer and sing. I'm just not that type of person. So that's a drama, isn't it? So in a way, I'm stuck. You know, this is myself. I'm stuck between ecology, because I don't want to be reprinting more and more scores. You know, so I have the exact verbatim. And nor do I want to miss the notes or their arrangement of it. And so I'm like, well, either make it up, you know, make it up, save the planet, try to make it look pretty or sound pretty, and then the objective of it next. My gosh. Yeah, so anyway, so singing is a drama. And all of this, and with the bright moon, you know, I'm like, oh my gosh, yeah. And so there is the ego self is just crushed, because I don't have that what do you call it, that build, you know. I don't have that pretty build of all their warm, you know, that they give such a gift, don't they, because of their prowess. They've given me such a gift. Oh, but when you don't have a teacher, and you don't have the money, you know, you're really self-taught. You know, so the teachers become these videos. The teachers become these MP3s. You know. So yeah. So I'm a little bit in that place. Anyway, so just. What is this? The competition and the moon and me and the distant star. Yeah. So it's a little bit of an odd mirror reflection moment of an emotional, like, you know, a lot of it, you know, it's just like, but, you know, I can sing like so many songs, you know, with, you know, as the headset on, I can sing so many songs, and yet, wow, I'm just reduced, and I'm just like, you know, trying to find which ones allow me through, good gosh, I found a few, so far, so I haven't completely given up. But yeah, I mean, that's the drama. Out of all of those songs, you know, it's just become a few with comfort. Just a few. So it's a dramatic time frame for any of us that are singers. that are self-taught. Yeah. I don't know. I guess I could have self-taught another way. Just didn't. I don't know. I guess I've always been on my own, haven't I? And in my being on my own, I guess it's just the way I went through it. The way I went through to train that song. Probably incorrect. Everybody will say, oh, that was wrong, that was incorrect, you wasted your time, blah, blah, blah. But that's the way it goes. You know, this is just the way it goes. I can still work on my pretty little swirls, though. I still remember how. It's just, it's often, gosh dang it. It was so much easier before, you know, easier. And you actually find the delving, it is a delve into the instrument body more. You have to delve into your instrument body more to bring the song out. And, oh my gosh, yeah, I feel kind of intimidated to do so. Kind of intimidated. But, yeah, that's what it is. It's about the drama of that body waking up and being a beautiful violin, being that beautiful instrument that's played, you know, that you are playing as a self. And so yeah, that's where I'm at. I'm waking up my body instrument, if that makes any sense. Yeah. My gosh, yeah, it's a funny one. Yeah, you don't find yourself chicken, for sure. You find yourself chicken to go to where you were used to. Yeah. All right. Anyway, hoota. Yeah. Arr, what a moon, you know, the boss of everything, you know, so big and bright, you know, it's a takeover moon. Wow.